Hello learners, our today's discussion is on mutual fund, and in our today discussion we will discuss about what is a mutual fund, how mutual funds work, structure of the mutual fund, types of mutual fund schemes, and then the advantages of mutual funds. So first of all, what is mutual funds? Mutual fund is a trust that pools the saving of a number of small investors who share a common financial goal. The money thus collected is then invested by the fund manager in different types of securities depending upon the scheme's stated objectives. So learner, mutual fund is a trust or an organization who collect the money from the different investors, create a pool of that money, and then fund manager use that money, invest that money in different kinds of securities, financial securities, as per the scheme's objectives. So these are the different kinds of securities, financial securities, where the fund manager invests the money. These are the money market instruments, commodity market, debt market, gilt or government securities, equity shares, and gold funds. So these are the securities where the where the fund manager invests the investor's money. The mutual fund issue units to the investor in return of the investment, in return of their investment. And so mutual fund issue units to the investors. Like if you invest in some company, you get the shares. If you invest in some equity share of a company, you get the share certificate. But in case of mutual fund, the mutual fund issue units to their investors. And the income earned from these investment and capital appreciation realized by the schemes are shared by its units in proportion to the number of units owned by them. So that whatever the income earned, whatever the capital appreciation is realized, that is distributed among the unit holders according to the investment made by them. These units have some price, and this is called the net asset value. The net asset value of per unit can be calculated with this formula, that is market value of securities minus liabilities divided by number of units issued. So this is how the value of per unit can be calculated. For example, if the market value of the securities of a scheme is rupees 200 lakh and the liabilities are 10 lakh, the mutual fund has issued 10 lakh units of rupees 10 each to the investor, then the NAV per unit of fund is rupees 19. So market value of securities here are 200 lakh. We will deduct liabilities of the mutual fund company, that is 10 lakh, and this is divided by number of unit issued, and number of units are 10 lakh. So the net asset value per unit will be rupees 19. And this, since the market value of the securities changes every day, so the NAV of the scheme also varies on day-to-day basis. So this NAV of rupees 19 doesn't remain same every day. It will fluctuate. It will sometimes will go up or go down according to the market value of the securities or the number of units and the number of units issued. So mutual funds are regulated by SEBI, and SEBI give this definition of mutual fund. Mutual funds means a fund established in the form of trust to raise monies through the sale of units to the public or a section of public under one or more schemes for investing in securities, including the money market instruments or gold related instrument. So this definition is given by SEBI. Next are the mutual fund ideal for investors who lack of knowledge or skill of investing in stock market directly. So those who have less knowledge or have less expertise about the stock market, or those who are new to the investment world, for them, the mutual fund is a good option. Investment through mutual fund is a good option. Those who want to grow their wealth but do not have the inclination or time to research stock market, for them also the mutual fund is a good option. Some people, they have no time or they are busy in their work and they have no time to research the stock market. So they can invest their money through the mutual funds. And next is who wish to invest only small amounts. So those investors who have small saving and small amount and they want to invest. So mutual fund is also a good option for them. For example, if I have a saving of rupees 50,000 and I want to invest my money in that in a stock market, I want to purchase the MRF company's share. MRF company is that Indian multinational of tire company. So I want to invest my 50,000 in that company, but only one share of that company is is around rupees 80,000. For the small investor like me, it is not possible to invest in that MRF share. So what will I do? I will invest in the mutual fund. And in mutual fund, the pool of money is created. And it may be happen that fund manager invest some money in that MRF company and purchase the share of that MRF company. So through mutual fund, it is possible for me to get the MRF share. So MRF share will come into my portfolio. So it is only through the mutual fund. If I invest through the mutual fund, then it is possible that different kinds of stocks, different types of companies, they come in my portfolio. So mutual fund is a good option for the small investor also. So next is how mutual funds work. So this is the diagram of how mutual fund works. So first of all, the investor, they pool their money and invest in the mutual fund schemes. And the fund manager use the investor money to purchase the different investment products like stock, bonds, money, market instruments, etc. And when these products, they generate return, then these returns are distributed back to the investor according to their proportion, according to the units they held. So this is how the mutual funds work. So next is the three-tier structure of mutual fund. So mutual fund house, they are consist of sponsor, trustees, and asset management company. So this is how the structure looks. First is the sponsor. Sponsor are the person who basically conceptualize the idea of starting a mutual fund business. So sponsors, they conceptualize the idea of starting a mutual fund business. And the sponsor can be, as per the SEBI regulation, sponsors can be a financial institution, bank, or a public or a private company. So these sponsors, they apply for the mutual fund company, and they make application to SEBI for the registration of mutual fund company. And if the sponsor has the necessary credential, SEBI will issue the certificate of registration. So what are these necessary credentials? These are that the sponsor must have experience of 5 years in financial services. Next is, they must be a profit-making company 3 out of last 5 years. Next is, last 5 years, net worth of the company must be positive. Means their asset must be more than their liability for the last 5 years. And the sponsor must contribute at least 40% of the net worth of the AMC. So these are some conditions which the sponsors have to meet. And after that, the SEBI issue them the certificate. And after getting certificate, next step is to form a trust. And then sponsor of the mutual fund, they create a trust. and this trust have a must have a board of trustees, like a board of directors in the company. So the minimum strength of the board must be of 4 members. So minimum 4 trustees must be there. And out of the whole board members, 2/3 members must be independent directors. Means these people, 2/3 people, they have no relation with the sponsors in any way. And the primary role is to ensure that mutual fund is operating as per the SEBI regulation, and these trustees, they have to ensure that they have to ensure to protect the interest of the unit holders. And the board of trustee may not engage in day-to-day operation of the mutual funds. So for daily operations, they appoint managers, which is called the AMC, and other team members. So they are the trustees, and they appoint the managers of the mutual fund. Next is the asset management company, which is called the manager of the mutual fund. So after trustee, the most important entity of mutual fund is its AMC, asset management company. So here in the asset management company, all the operations are done, like from floating of mutual fund schemes to the issuing units to the investors till the redemption of units. So all these operations are done at this by this asset management company. So AMC of a mutual fund is formed as per the Companies Act 1956. The AMC must also be registered with the Government of India. After an AMC is registered, it will start functioning as a full-fledged company. This is one reason why we see the following 3 types of AMCs in India: private limited company, wholly owned subsidiary of an already public limited company, or joint venture between Indian or overseas companies. So these AMC, in the name of the trust, they float and manages the different investment scheme as per the SEBI regulation and as per the investment management agreement signed with the trustees. When trustees are forming this asset management company, it's their duty to appoint the manager who will in turn run the AMC. So the trustee, they appoint the CEO of the mutual fund company, fund manager, chief investment officer, and chief marketing officer. So these are the people who do work on behalf of the trustees. So this is the example of the 3-tier structure. So I have taken 2 mutual fund companies, that is SBI Mutual Fund and ICICI Prudential Mutual Fund. So the SBI Mutual Fund, sponsor of the SBI Mutual Fund are SBI and Amundi. It's a joint venture between the SBI and Amundi. Amundi is a European asset management company. And whereas in case of ICICI Prudential Mutual Fund, their sponsors are Prudential Bank and ICICI Bank Limited. So here is also a joint venture between the 2 companies. One is a multinational company based in England, and another is ICICI Bank. So their sponsor, then they create a trust. The SBI Mutual Fund, the trust, the name of trust is SBI Mutual Fund Trustee Company Private Limited, and the ICICI Mutual Fund is in the name of trust is ICICI Prudential Trust Limited. So then the trust form the, so then these trust form the AMC. SBI Mutual Fund is known as the SBI Fund Management Private Limited, and ICICI Prudential Mutual Fund is known as ICICI Prudential Asset Management Company Limited. So this is the structure of the, this is the 3-tier structure of the mutual fund. So next are the depositories. They are appointed by the asset management company, and they are the financial institution. It is the responsibility of the depository to hold all the financial assets or securities safely in its custody. So depository hold the financial securities in its custody. The clearing and settlement of financial securities, as well as the book entry transfer of these securities, are all possible with the these depositories. Then is the transfer agent. AMC appoint the transfer agents. The transfer agents communicate with the investors. They maintain data of investors, and transfer agent are also responsible for issue and redemption of units of mutual funds. Next comes the registrar. Again, it is the AMC who appoints the registrar for its mutual funds. And these days, generally, the role of transfer agent and the registrar is performed by the same company. The main function of the registrar is at the data entry and send account statement to the investors, etc. Next are the auditors. As per the Companies Act, all companies must get their book of accounts audited by an external financial auditor. These auditors are basically certified chartered accountants. It is the auditor, they also check and certifies the financial reports prepared by the mutual fund companies. So this is about the structure of the mutual fund. So next is the types of mutual fund schemes. Learners, in India, there are 3,500 plus schemes are available. So the investor select the schemes according to his risk profile, investment objective, or the time horizon, means that for the time period for which he want to make an investment. So there are different schemes are available to the investors. So they are on the basis of structure. We have open-ended schemes, closed-ended schemes, and interval schemes. By management, there are actively managed schemes and passively managed schemes. Then by investment objectives, there are growth schemes, income schemes, balanced schemes, money market liquid schemes. By asset class, the schemes are classified into equity, debt, hybrid, solution-oriented schemes, and other schemes are also, which includes the ETFs, that is exchange-traded funds, fund of funds, index funds. So let's discuss each of these schemes one by one. So by structure, we have open-ended scheme. First one is the open-ended scheme. Open-ended type of mutual fund is in India is where an investor can buy and sell units anytime throughout the year. So as the name suggested, open-ended. So they are open for the investors. An investor can anytime can buy and sell unit of these schemes. There is no restriction on entry and exit. Any investor can anytime buy the units, and they can anytime redeem their units. So there is no restrictions on buying and selling of these schemes. These funds are highly liquid, as they can be redeemed as per the daily NAV. So they are highly liquid. You can easily convert your units into cash by selling these units, by redeeming these units at the daily base of NAV value. The example of these schemes are like Axis Blue Chip Fund, Mirae Asset Large Cap Fund, SBI Mid Cap Fund, etc. So these are some example of these open-ended schemes. Next is the closed-ended schemes. So as the name suggested, closed-ended schemes. So these schemes are open for investors for some particular time period, that is called NFO, that is new fund offer, that is open for 7 or 14 days. Means in those days, investors can invest in that scheme, and after that scheme is closed till the maturity, and the maturity period is ranging from 2 to 15 years. Mean before 2 years, you cannot encash your units. So they are the closed schemes. They are open for a particular time period, and after that they are closed till the maturity. But the closed-ended schemes, they are listed on the stock exchange. So investor can buy and sell the units on the stock exchange. The example of these closed-ended schemes are the ELSS funds, that are equity-linked security scheme funds, which carry a compulsory 3-year lock-in period. Means if you invest in equity-linked savings scheme, you cannot encash your units up till 3 years. That is called the lock-in period. So these are the closed-ended schemes. Next are the interval schemes. Interval schemes, they combine the features of both open-ended and closed-ended scheme. Investor can buy these schemes anytime throughout the year during the trading hours, and also these schemes are listed on the stock exchange, and they can also buy and sell them on the stock exchange also. So example of interval schemes are like a UTI fixed interval income fund scheme, that is the scheme which is provided by UTI, that is Unit Trust of India. Then Reliance Interval Fund, so the Reliance provider scheme of this interval fund. So these are the schemes by structure. Next are by management. By management, we have two schemes: actively managed mutual funds and passively managed mutual funds. In actively managed mutual funds are what? These types of mutual funds are actively managed by fund manager who constantly buy and sell shares as per their research and expertise. So the fund manager, who are professionally qualified and experienced people, they constantly look at the share market, that which stock is doing well, which sector is performing well, and then accordingly they buy and sell shares. So they actively perform on the in the scheme. So equity mutual fund, except index funds, are mostly actively managed funds. And actively mutual funds are suitable for long-term investors. Second is the passively managed mutual funds. So the main objective of passively managed mutual funds are to replicate the benchmark index. The fund manager does not take active interest in managing the portfolio of such funds. For example, there is HDFC Index Sensex Plan. So in this HDFC Index Sensex Plan, if you take this scheme, what will the investor do? He will simply invest your money in the BSE Sensex. And that Sensex, that is an index of 30 shares. So your money is invested in that 30 shares by the investment manager. And another example is ICICI Prudential Nifty Index Fund, that scheme by the ICICI, where the which follow the Nifty index. Nifty is an index of 50 shares. So all the money of the investor will be invested in that 50 shares of the Nifty index. So here the manager, he will simply invest their money into the index. Next is the by investment objectives. By investment objective, we have growth schemes. And the aim of this scheme is to provide capital appreciation over the medium to long term. Now, what is capital appreciation? Capital appreciation is when the value of investment increases over a period of time. So suppose there is an investor who invests 10,000, and after 6 months, there is a capital appreciation of 16,000. So the difference between the 16,000 and 10,000, 6,000 is the capital appreciation. So basically the growth schemes, they provide the capital appreciation. And in such kind of schemes, the fund manager, they invest in the equity shares. They make investment in the equity shares. Although equity shares are considered to be the risky investment, but here the growth is also growth of the scheme is also very high. Loss can be happen, but the profits are high in growth schemes. Next is the income schemes. So aim of this scheme is to provide regular and steady income to the investor. The investors who want a regular and steady income, for them these income schemes are they opt such kind of schemes. So these schemes generally invest in fixed income securities such as bonds and corporate debentures. Capital appreciation is scheme in such kind of schemes may be limited because the risk these schemes are less risky. So the return is what the interest they get on these securities, and the capital appreciation is very less in such kind of schemes. Only they get the fixed income that is monthly or annually or semi-annually. Then is the balanced scheme. And balanced scheme where the which has both the growth and income, where both growth and income by periodically distributing a part of the income and capital gains they earn. So they invest in both shares and fixed income securities in the proportion indicated in their OPA documents. So in balanced scheme, the fund manager invests both in the income schemes and the growth schemes proportionately. Then there is money market or liquid scheme. So the aim is to provide easy liquidity, preservation of capital, and moderate income. So these schemes invest in safe short-term money market instruments like treasury bills, certificate of deposits, commercial paper, call money market. So these money market schemes, they invest in the money market instruments, short-term money market instruments. And return on these schemes may fluctuate depending upon the rate of interest prevailing in the market. So they are also the safest schemes. Money market schemes are also considered to be the safe schemes. But here the risk is low and the return and is also comparatively low than the growth schemes. Next, we have the by investment class. In 2007, SEBI classified the scheme on the basis of their class. So first is the equity mutual fund. So equity mutual fund invest in equities or stock of the company. They are highly risky, but they also have track record of generating superior return. Equity mutual funds are perfect for long-term investors and for those investors who can take risk. So in equity, mutual funds are good for that investor who are risk takers. Equity mutual funds are further divided into large cap funds, small cap funds, mid cap funds, and multi cap funds. So the fund manager invest the money in these kind of funds, the large cap, small cap, mid cap, or multi cap fund. The second one is debt mutual funds. Debt mutual fund invest in fixed income securities, and the debt mutual funds invest in like bonds, debentures, treasury bill, commercial paper, certificate of deposit. The investor get the fixed income. They are less risky and they are suitable for those investors who don't want to take risk, who are risk averse, and who want a steady income. So this investment is good. So this debt investment is good for the risk averse investors. The third is hybrid mutual funds. So hybrid mutual fund schemes invest in mix of equity stocks and fixed income securities. So these hybrid funds are also known as balanced funds. Next come the other schemes. In other schemes, we have the ELSS scheme, that is equity linked saving scheme, that is a tax saving scheme. So these schemes offer tax incentives to the investor under tax law as prescribed from time to time. If you invest in ELSS, that is equity linked saving scheme, then you will get some tax benefit also. Then next is the exchange traded funds, known as ETF. ETF are a mix of open-ended and closed-ended scheme. ETFs like closed-ended scheme, they are listed on the stock exchange and trading is possible on a daily basis. Like shares, they are trade on the stock exchange. Like that, ETF can also be traded on the stock exchange. But their price is usually very close to NAV or the underlying assets. Next are the funds of funds. In this scheme, the mutual fund invests the pooled money in the schemes of other mutual fund company. So So if there is a, the SBI mutual fund, so if you invest in the fund of funds scheme of SBI mutual fund, then the SBI will invest in the other mutual fund, in the schemes of other mutual fund, like SBI invest in the ICICI mutual fund schemes. So that is the, that is called the funds of fund schemes. So learners, next is the advantages of mutual funds. When the investor invest in mutual funds, what kind of advantages he get? So first one is the professional management. When the investor invest in the mutual fund, they get the services, they get the services of professionally qualified manager. These managers, they research on different companies based on their micro and macroeconomic factors, and on the basis of their research, they decide the best stock to invest in so that maximum profit can be generated for the unit holders. So the investor get the services of the professional people. Next is the diversification. Another important advantage of mutual fund is that it offers diversification. The pooled money is invested in multiple stock across the sectors, market capitalization, and asset classes depending upon the investment objectives of the scheme. So the loss incurred in one sector or asset class is offset by profit made in another sector or asset class. So diversification reduces the overall risk of the portfolio. So these mutual funds, they give the benefit of, they give the advantage of diversification to get the different kind of stocks in your basket. Then is the liquidity. The third important advantage of a mutual fund is the liquidity. Mutual funds are highly liquid as they can be easily bought and sold in short term during market hours. So investor can easily sell and buy mutual funds during their trading hours. And however, closed-ended mutual funds, interval mutual funds, and equity funds, including this ELSS funds, that is equity linked savings scheme, they are the exception as they have locking period and cannot be readily liquidated. Next is the cost. Now, another important advantage of mutual fund is their low cost. Due to the huge economies of scale, mutual fund scheme charges as little as 1 to 2% as the fund management expenses. So as lots of investors, they pool their pool, they create a pool of money. So the economies of scale. So the cost of the management is also less. So the management also charges less cost for the services they provide. Then is the tax efficiency. A unique advantage of mutual fund is that they offer tax benefits. Investment in ELSS is exempt under Section 80 up to rupees 1.5 lakhs. Next is the affordability. Mutual funds are also affordable as you can start from as little as rupees 500 per month. You can also opt for SIP, that is systematic investment plan, or lump sum investment based on your budget. So so small investors, so if mutual funds, through mutual fund investment is affordable for the small investors. Small investor means who have less money or who have small savings. So they can also easily invest in the stock market through the mutual funds. So this affordability of mutual fund is the biggest advantage of the mutual fund, as it allows the retail investors to start investing with a small amount. So these are the advantages of mutual funds. Next are the disadvantages of mutual funds. The first disadvantage is high cost. Some mutual funds have high cost associated with them. If you exit before the stipulated time, then you also incur exit load charges. So if you sell your funds before that lock-in period, before the maturity period, then mutual fund companies, they charge some charges, which is called the exit load charges. Second disadvantage is dilution of funds. The biggest disadvantage of a mutual fund is diversification. Diversification has averaging effect on your investment. If it saves you from suffering the major loss, it also prevents you to make gains also. Hence, it recommends that you shouldn't invest in too many funds and over diversify the portfolio. So over diversification of portfolio, when you add more funds, when lots of funds are added in the portfolio, then it creates a dilution of funds. Next is the lock-in period. Another disadvantage of mutual fund is that some mutual funds are like ELSS funds and come with a lock-in period of 3 years. So during this lock-in period, you cannot withdraw your invested amount for 3 years. So additionally, if you invest in closed-ended fund, then you will not be able to liquidate this investment in case of any emergency. So lock-in period is also be considered as a disadvantage of mutual fund. If some person needs funds before the maturity period, then at that time it's very difficult for him to liquidate his units. Next is the fluctuating returns. Another disadvantage of mutual fund is that mutual funds returns are not guaranteed and keep on fluctuating as per the market. So there is a fluctuation. Whenever there is a fluctuation in market, sometimes market goes up, sometimes downs. So the returns are not guaranteed. Hence, the investor need to be aware of the risk profile of the fund before investing. So these are the disadvantages of investing in mutual funds. So learners, this is all about the mutual funds. I hope this session give you some insights about the mutual funds, like how mutual fund works, what is the structure of mutual fund, and what are the different schemes available to the investors who can invest in the mutual funds. So this is all about this session. Thank you.